Now, she's the current Miss Lancashire and Deputy Miss England, but even then, Mary-Kate Kelly nearly fell victim to rogue model agencies offering a shortcut to fame at a hefty price.
Mary-Kate, who's from Chorley, has enlisted the help of Fixers. That's the campaign that gives young people a voice to warn aspiring models not to pay through the nose for the chance to be famous.
Last year, I was in the Miss England final and I was awarded Deputy Miss England, but off the back of that, I've now been placed as Miss Lancashire 2014. I was encouraged to look for a modelling agency, which I did, and I found it quite challenging. After filling in loads of applications and getting a lot of rejections, finally, a couple came back, but it all turned out to be a scam. I'm Mary-Kate McKay, I'm 23 and I'm from Preston. I'm working with Fixers to warn people about these companies that are preying on people who want to become a model. I'm making a film to show people that these guys are only after your money.
I was really excited when I finally got a really positive reply from a firm telling me that I was exactly what they wanted.
The lady advised me that they were going to send me for a really high-end photo shoot, and so if I didn't respond there and then, I would miss the opportunity, which for me was terrifying.
But a couple of days before, my mum came across this website highlighting all the rogue agencies. And unfortunately, the place where I was going to go to for this high-profile photo shoot was the top of the list.
The photos I would have had to pay for, and they're ranging from thousands and thousands of pounds. And they would have told me that if I hadn't bought these photos, then I was never going to make it in the industry. When I realised that this was a scam, I was devastated.
What is so terrible about this, and why it's such a blot on the model industry, is that it is kidding these young people, and boys as well as girls, that they've got what it takes, when they know perfectly well that it's hopeless. And they're taking huge amounts of money off them. These people are fanning the flames of the desire to be famous and then exploiting it ruthlessly. An aspiring model does not need a portfolio.
The message that I really want to get across to young people as well as their parents is just educating them, raising awareness about rogue agencies, because, you know, you could be handing over hundreds and hundreds of pounds for something that isn't legitimate.
I was out shopping when a man approached me and he said he's representing an agency.
Today I'm talking to Saba Shakir about what happened to her.
They were just saying that we've got, like, a minimum of £500 contract for you, but all I had to do was just pay a small amount of money for my portfolio and all of that work was mine.
How did it make you feel when it turned out to be a lie?
When you're told that you can become like a next superstar, you do kind of like start thinking that, yes, I can do it, I can make it. But when I found out, I was really, really upset. I was like, my hopes were built up so high and they just came crashing down.
I am doing some modelling now, which for me is really positive. For me to have a voice on this issue is an absolute privilege. If I could stop just one person from being scammed, then my work here is done.
Yes, people beware. And you can find out more about the great work the Fixers are doing by going to our story on our website. Click on the link, go to itv.com/Granada.
Yeah, really interesting piece, that. Well, we're moving on to sport now, and at the risk of annoying Liverpool fans, Manchester City are almost there.